Good evening, everyone. So nice to see you all. Thank you for taking your time out of your busy schedule to join us tonight. 大家晚上好，很高兴见到您，感谢您在百忙之中抽空参加此次活动。Dr. Minfu Liu graduated from Alberta University, works as a statistics officer at Alberta Health Services, one of the Board of Director of WS Immigrant and Multicultural Services Society and WS Writers and many other associations. He has numerous publications in English and in Chinese. He has received numerous awards. Well, how can this scientist, also a poet, started to write poems? Because of a friend's challenging, as he said. Now he enjoys writing. 刘明富老师，你们很多人都非常的熟悉。他曾用网名微光虚实，加拿大阿尔伯塔大学动物育种与遗传学博士，主要研究方向为生物统计学，现任阿尔伯塔省卫生厅高级统计师，文氏移民与多元文化服务协会理事，文氏作家协会等多个文学社团副会长、理事等。诗文作品常见于海内外报刊和网络，并入编几十部文学专辑，屡获佳奖。这样一枚妥妥的理工男，在花甲之年接受了一位朋友的挑战，开始写诗。三年前开始研究英语格律诗。The classic poem I Wandered Lonely as a Cloud, also called Daffodils by William Wordsworth.Is about nature's beauty with a mixed happiness and loneliness. 威廉·华兹华斯，英国浪漫主义诗人，与雪莱·拜伦齐名，也是湖畔诗人的代表，桂冠诗人。他最经典的诗篇之一《我像一朵云，孤独地徘徊》，也叫《水仙花》，讲述的是大自然的美，融合了幸福的孤独，孤独的幸福。这是不是跟我们现在疫情中的处境有点相似？以我们现在的处境，应该更能体会华兹华斯诗中的感受，对吧？April is the National Poetry Month. 四月是加拿大国家诗歌月。Let's welcome Dr. Liu and let's enjoy his sharing tonight. 让我们一起来聆听刘老师今晚的分享。有请刘老师。
谢谢，谢谢欣源过奖了啊。今天这个在这里头跟大家分享，也就是分享我的一点经验。一点经历吧，这个经历的来自呢，也是经过三年的辛苦。当我第一次碰到这一首诗的时候啊，真是感觉到哇，这个诗里的各个元素非常非常的多，是我把所有的东西一些困扰我的东西在这里能够得到解决。Thank you, Sophia, for your introduction.All the good words, even though it's more than I deserve, but thank you anyway. It's great to meet everybody. All the good words, even though it's more than I deserve, but thank you anyway. It's great to meet everybody in this group. And it's a small group, but it's good for our, maybe have more and more interactions. Well,As Sophia already mentioned that I become a poet, it's just because a friend of mine challenged me and so that I try. I kind of enjoy writing now, but I also recognize like every poet, writing poem is not an easy job. It's not an easy job at all, but,For the last few years, I already start and cannot stop right now. So kind of enjoy. 也就是说，我成为一个写诗是完全出于朋友的挑战。也是这个原因，也好像是逼上梁山。作为我的朋友来说呢，我好像是一个半路杀出的程咬金。也就会这两把板斧 Today, I would like to share with you the analysis of the great, of this great poem, I Wandered, Lonely as a Cloud, by William Wordsworth. When this poem was brought to my attention, my response is simply, wow, it has everything I try to learn about the metric poem or the traditional English in 3 years with only partial success, leave me with many puzzles. This poem is my eye opener and my puzzle is my puzzle solver. So, 当这首诗，我首看到这首诗引起我的注意的时候，我的是非常惊讶的，说这首诗真好。我的感觉是说，从这里头我可以学到，我花了3年的时间来学这个 metric poem， 还有很多很多的疑难问题，好像这一首诗里头都能给我提出答案。这是我特别感惊讶的。So now just have a few words about William. William Wordsworth was born in April 1770 and died in April 1850, 80 years old. At that time, think about in the 18th century and the 19th century, he is really, really long life. He was a long life. He is the founder or to help to launch the Romantic Age in English literature. And he is the poet, Lawrence, and also he is the poet of Lake District. In summary, he was and he is a tower figure standing along with those famous romantic poets such as Lord Byron, Percy Shelley, and William Blake. 这个秦源已经给我们介绍了William Wordsworth 是一个罗曼文学的一个代表性的人物长寿桂冠诗人湖畔诗人这他是一个很伟大的人物跟他并列的像有这个白人爵士英国诗人 Perry Shelley 和 William Blake. So English metric English poem actually just like the Chinese traditional have the rhythm. It's a very regular rhythm. It's a when you read, it's really have the tunes, the ups, the downs. Okay, I try to read, but I wander lonely as a cloud. I wander lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills. When all at once I saw a cloud, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Continuous as a star that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way, that stretched in never-ending line among the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glimpse, tossing their heads in sprintly dancing. The waves beside them danced, but they after did the sparkling waves in glee. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company, I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the shoe to me had brought. For often, when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mode, there flash up on the inward eye, which is a blessing of solitude. And then my heart with pressure fills and dance with daffodil deals. I try to read with the rhythm, but I try my best. There are several translations, and then we can, I think I jump to the translations just to get an idea what this. There are many translations. I choose a one is a modern translation in the free form. It's from one of our the attendees in this conference. Okay.
它是这样翻译的：我像一朵云，孤独地徘徊。我像漂浮于山谷，与山丘和山丘子上的一朵云，孤独地徘徊。突然发现一大片金色的水仙花，在湖水边、树荫下，与微风中翩翩起舞。 连续不断地向银河里无数闪烁的繁星，沿着河湾的边缘向外无穷无尽的深堰，我瞥了一眼这上万枝花正在明快的舞姿里摆摇头。旁边的海浪也在舞动，但水仙花的欢舞超过了波光粼粼的海浪，如此。 快活的旅伴，唯吾与如此快活的旅伴为伍，世人怎能不欢欣鼓舞？我逆视着，却很少想到，这景致已带给我多少财富。我时常一谈而卧，或是脑子空空，或是陷入沉思中。 金色的水仙花会突然闪现入眼，带来幽静的快乐。于是我的心就充满了喜悦，并与水仙花一起共舞。现在我们回到分析这一部分。This perfect, this perfect metric poem, I wonder. Lonely as a cloud, offer us a great opportunity to understand almost all elements of a classical poetry, like a footer, it's a 音部, meter, 可以标着节律, and 也可以翻成别的, and the rhymer, is 韵脚, 和 more important, 这首是, in the plot, 就设计, with mirrors the plot used in the traditional Chinese quatrain. 这反映着了中国这个四言诗。这个诗它有里头有音部，有这个音节，有这个 rhymer, 还有它的设计是我们要分析的。English is a very interesting language. It's put two syllables together like this case, but in other cases, you can put more syllables together, give them a name called foot. Really make me people thinking, when you read a line of a poem, you are walking step by step, foot one, foot two, foot three, foot four. For this one, until you write to the fourth foot. So 英语这个名字也是特别有兴趣，他把这一个行里头分成一小块一小块的，就像音乐中的音节，它叫 footer， 它叫部音部或者叫韵部，或者是名字比较多一些，叫音部相对比较好一些。就像我们读一行诗的时候呢， 我们就像在走路，要一步一步的走。啊，那么他雇用这个非常相似中国的平平仄仄平平仄，非常非常的相似，但是它语言不同，它的副词的含义跟我们中文还是有区别的。That is the components we are going. And also in this poem for the second line, and what was actually very skillfully.To put over valleys, two words with four syllables into, combine them into over vowels. And everybody knows if you read from the context, and then reduce the four syllable into two, and it's a fit, the forfeiter, forfeit, meet a line perfectly. Very calm down. 也就是说作者呢很巧妙的把 over valley 这两个字四个音节 syllable 巧妙的把它结合成 over vowels 也一下子就减少了两个音节使第二行也同时也是四个音部八个音节不受影响这是非常巧妙的。我们读到别的诗的时候，别人像 William Blake 也经常用这种技术。yeah, that is the skills of the romantic poetry used quite often. And to emphasize scansing, this English with scansing or counting of feet in a metric or line.Just for simplicity, 中文叫做节律分析 is based on pronunciation. That's what I want to share tonight with everybody. It's based on pronunciation. Sounds, any silence sound, vowels, does not count, does not constitute a syllable. Usually it's a very difficult one because we have to have a better understanding of the English pronunciation and,In order to write, but nowadays people may not write a metric poem, but just try to learn the elegance from it. My understanding is after we do a good analysis of this poem, and we will be in a very good position for the other.For the other poem, we try to analyze or we try to scan him. 这首诗呢，因为它概括的比较全面，比较多。当我们都做了一个典型的分析以后，会帮助我们分析其他的诗。Now I summarize the characteristic of this poem. 现在我总结一下这首诗的特点。这首诗特点它我先讲中文吧它是根据声调和音节来决定这个 meter 的来决定这一行它的每一步 footer 是一个 ambic 就是像发音 I am 一个 unaddress 一个 stress 一个 short 一个 long一个unstressed I am 就英语经常会出现这是最普通的footer 在日常language中也有这种 footer 就是说 I told you what to do 意思就是这样的跳跃英语meter 就是一个 line 这个 meter 是包含着每一行包含着四个 iambic feet就是四个音部它的押韵的格式每一段是四行押韵的格式是 ABABCC 就是第一行和第三行押一个韵第二行和第四行押一个韵第五行和第六行六行押一个韵每段六行and also the 这个设计是按照起承转合，按照典型的中国的是绝句的那种方法，是种巧合了。And English part is the characteristics of this poem is the meter type is an essential syllabic meter, and the footer is an iambic filter. Meter is a tetrameter. Each line consists of four iambic feet. Rhymer type or rhymer pattern for each stanza is 一段It's A, B, A, B, C, C. And also this plot is very interesting. It's almost like a Chinese 七绝哦绝句。Just to mention that as a modern poet, we are free to do our creative work without any constraints. However, a good understanding of the elegance of the elements of classical poetry will definitely be very helpful in both our appreciation of the classical poetry and our modern creative work. 就是说我们现代诗人呢不一定实际上我们很大多数情况是不写这种古体诗的。但是我们要理解这种古体诗是写的相当美的，我们通过理解，我们对我们写现代诗也是很有帮助的。这一点呢说呢，洛夫先生也曾经强调过，这个古典诗词的沉淀，对于发展现代诗词是非常非常重要的。有一次飞马先生做一个报告的时候呢，有人问他说，飞马先生你想不想写传统诗词，飞马先生答得很幽默也很好，他说我没有时间去写经典诗词，但是我建议大家要多看多学经典诗词。这是他这一席话说明点着两个问题，写经典诗要花好多好多的时间的，因为他的推敲的过程，他的有一些限制，的确是一个的确是一个影响，的确是也怎么说呢，也是一个 obstruction， 从某种角度来说，但是 however。We try to learn all the beauties from it. It's very help us in creating creative work in modern world with modern styles. Okay, now let's do some practical scansion. 现在我们做一下这个列句分析。我们主要列句分析就看一下 stanza one， 就是段落 one。在他这个诗的结构上的是 initiation， 就是起。他这个是 I wandered lonely as a cloud。前面这是 this line have four feet with eight syllables。这一行里头有四个音部，八个音节。他们是怎样，我们怎样来 count 它，我这个来跟大家分享一下。 Now we will share how to count the feet and the syllables in line one. Any syllables have to have a vowel and or a combination of a consonant and a vowel.任何一个音节它或者是一个独立的元音，或者是一个与复音相符合的一个音节。这样是 That is I want. This is just like I am. I want is the first feet. Remember, we are using syllable. Der long is the second. It's the second fate. Now, the very interesting things happen. That's I blame the poem didn't follow the rule. Actually, I didn't know before. Pronunciation is more important than spelling. I wondered, this E, der, this wondered, this E is a silent, doesn't count. Lonely, this E after N is a silence, not count. Li, us, is the third foot. Li, even though L-Y is a consonant, but pronunciation is a li, is a vowels. So li us is the third foot. Cloud is the fourth. You see, this is for the first couple of years, I just have so much problem to do scanning. I gave up many times. And I really trust this, the author. And then I see why I try to figure out. And during the process, I needed to connect the dots. So that is the first line. 这就是第一行的这两个音节。 Der 和 long 是第二个音节，这个我这个鼠标点这个 e 是 silence 不发音，不算。这个 ly 虽然作为字母在这里是个复音，但是它的发声是元音，li us a us a 当然了，这后面比较清楚了，是一个音节 cloud。 是另外一个音节，我们现在用了，哎呀，我这到这用这个时间用太多了。The 我 just analyze the two lines. The second line is that flows is a first footer. On high is a second footer. Over vowels is the third one with the e follow l. Is a silence and hills. Yeah, that's the second one. The second line, it also have four feet, eight syllables. And 第二行也是四个音部，八个音节，就是 that flows 是一个 on high is a second, over vowels 是third。 那个 L 后面的 E 是个 silence and hills the fourth， 我们就讲，就分析这两个，大家就可以，如果你有感兴趣的话，有时间的话，一点点你就会发现，是 enjoyable。 我想陈良先生肯定是在这，他搞数学的嘛，他这个房子 pattern 还是很感兴趣。现在我们看一下韵脚 ，Now we are look at the rhyme, rhymers。 Rhymers already said that there are six lines with the pattern A, B, A, B, C, C.